Now let's see an applet program to demonstrate lifecycle methods. We know that any applet is implemented with the help of five methods. They are init method, start method, paint method, stop method and destroy method. In this video, we will write an applet program to demonstrate those five lifecycle methods. So let us write the program. So first we have to import applet package. So import space java.applet.*. Why? Because applet package contains applet class. Applet class contains several methods like init method, start method, stop method and destroy method. Next we have to import the second package. The second package is java.awt.*. AWT package contains component class. Component class contains paint method. Next we have to write applet code within comments. Here we have to use a tag called applet. The attributes of the applet tag are, the first one is code. Here code is nothing but Java class name. Let us assume that here name of the Java class is applet lifecycle. Applet lifecycle. Next we need to specify width of the applet. Let width is equal to 500. Next we have to specify height of the applet. Let height is equal to 500 pixels. Next, closing applet tag element. Just close the applet tag. Next, close the comments. Next we have to create the class which extends applet class. So here the access specifier must be public. So public space class space. Here what is the name of the class? Applet lifecycle is the name of the class. So applet lifecycle. Here if you want to create any applet program, then we have to create a class. That class must extends applet class. Extends applet class. Applet class is present in applet package. Okay. Next, in this program we have to write all those five methods. The first method is init method. So public void init method. In this, display some message system.out.println applet initialized. Applet initialized. So we are displaying this message. Next, let us write the second method. The second method is start method. So public void start method. So here also display some message on the with the help of system.out.println. So applet started. Here if you write anything in init method or start method or stop method or destroy method, then the corresponding content will be displayed in command prompt. If you want to display something on the applet, then we have to use a paint method. In paint method we have graphics class. So with the help of that graphics class object, we can display anything on the applet. So if we display anything with the help of system.out.println in init method or in start method or in stop method or in destroy method, then the corresponding content will be displayed in command prompt. If we want to display something on the applet, then we have to use a paint method. But in paint method, it is not possible to use system.out.println. In paint method, we should not use system.out.println. In paint method, we have graphics class object as the argument. That graphics class contains several methods. So with the help of those methods, we can print something on the applet. So next, close the start method. So next one, public void paint method. Paint method accepts graphics class object as the argument. So graphics g. Next, g dot draw string of, let us display some message, hello world. Hello world. Here drawString accepts three arguments. The first argument is string, the second argument is x coordinate, the third argument is y coordinate. Okay, so this is nothing but paint method. Next we have two more methods. So what are those methods? So public void stop. Public void stop. Here we have to use system.out.println applet stopped. our applet execution is stopped. So applet stopped. Next, close the stop method. So next we have one more method. What is that method? Destroy method. So public void destroy. Destroy method. Next, system.out.println. Applet destroyed. Applet destroyed. Next, close the destroy method. And after that, we have to close this class. Okay. So first we have to compile the program. So here, what is the name of the program? Applet lifecycle.java. So Java C space applet lifecycle.java. Applet lifecycle.java. So once we compile the program, then we will get applet lifecycle.class file. Next, in order to execute the applet program, we have to make use of applet viewer tool. Applet viewer tool is present in JDK. So how to execute an applet program is applet viewer space, applet viewer space, and here what is the name of the program? Applet lifecycle. Here the extension is .java only. We should not give .class file. So whenever we click on the enter here, then the applet viewer will go to the corresponding applet lifecycle.java program, and it checks what is the code name here. Here what is the code name? Applet lifecycle is the code name. Here applet lifecycle is nothing but .class file. Okay. So applet viewer executes the program with the help of applet lifecycle class. Okay. So first, which method will get executed? So here, what is the width of the applet? So this is nothing but width. So width is equal to some 500 pixels. Next, height is also 500 pixels. So this is nothing but height. Okay. This is nothing but height. Next, this is nothing but title bar. This one is nothing but status bar. So in title bar, applet viewer colon. So what is the name of the class here? Applet lifecycle. So it will be printed. Next, minus rectangle and class mark will be printed. And here applet will be printed. This is nothing but applet status bar. So whenever applet execution is started, then here applet started will be printed. If you click on minus, then applet stopped will be printed. If you click on this rectangle, then applet started will be printed. If you click on this cross mark, then applet destroyed will be printed. Okay. So first, what will happen is first init method will be executed. System.out.println applet initialized. So here we have some command prompt. We know that we compiles the program from the command prompt. Okay. So in command prompt, applet initialized will be printed. In command prompt, applet initialized will be printed. Next, public void start method, system.out.println, applet started will be printed. Next, we know that first init method will be executed. First init method will be executed. So system.out.println, applet initialized will be printed in command prompt. After executing init method, start method will get executed. So what is the code in start method? System.out.println, applet started. So applet started message will be printed in command prompt. Next, to public void paint graphics z. So here in paint method, it is not possible to use system.out.println. Here we are using paint method in order to paint the applet, in order to display something in the applet. Okay. So g.drawstring of, by using drawstring method, we can display a line of text. We can display some string on the applet. So here it accepts three parameters. The first parameter is nothing but string. Second parameter x coordinate. Third parameter y coordinate. Here x is nothing but top portion, 30 is nothing but left portion. Let it be first pixel, let it be second pixel, let it be third pixel. Likewise, let us assume that this is the 10th pixel. So this is nothing but top portion. Next, 30 is nothing but left coordinate. Let it be first pixel, second pixel, third pixel. Likewise, let it be 30 pixel. So from this pixel onwards, hello world message will be printed. Okay. Next. Next, let us assume that we clicked on this cross mark. So whenever we clicked on this cross mark, first stop method will get executed. So applet stopped will be printed in the command prompt. Or if you click on this minus, then also applet execution will get stopped. So if you click on this minus, minus stands for minimization. So our applet window will be minimized. So stop method will get executed. Okay. Next, if you click on this cross mark, okay, first the applet stop method will get executed, and after that destroy method will get executed. So applet destroy will be executed. Okay. So here in init method, in start method, in start method, in destroy method, we are using system.out.println, okay, to display something in the command prompt. Whereas in paint method, we are using graphics class methods in order to display information in the applet. So in this way, we can demonstrate applet lifecycle methods.